Now, vegetable farmers in Kabarole district say they've been affected by lack of water for irrigation and high prices for seedlings that are apparently imported into the country. Kabarole district is well known for growing vegetables like broccoli, cabbage, spinach, cucumber, tomatoes and onions, among others that are sold in the areas of Kasese, Chenjojo, Bundibujo, as well as other parts of the country. Let's have the details in the following report.
According to farmers, vegetable growing needs medium rains and sunshine since they are affected when the heat is too much and when the water is too much. Patrick Agaba, the chairperson of vegetable farmers in the district, says the cost of water for irrigation is high, with a jerrycan going for between 500 to 700 shillings. He adds that scarcity of seedling on the local market is another problem.
Broccoli, giko kimu nekichweka, ili mtuali kumi. Hata mtuali kumi kurora wagiki hanu mkatali, kakabundeire o karora angu, wasobara kuyamsentez, kikuwa angu hamuna kukua embibo inyakulimu ntaitu.
The COVID made it worse, with almost no clients coming in following the closure of schools and hotels and the general lockdown that limited transportation.
Korona yakatutwaza kubi ibintu ebimu amahoteli gakemera so tugaine abagenyi ibintu ebimu twayambibwaga amasomero amasomero gayemera abarukutwala ebyokulya ebimu kulya tibakubigura kurungi abakumentashe zaabo nceki.
Francis Mwesija, another farmer, says during the dry season he injects 2 million and only reaps profit of 500,000, which is way below compared to during a rainy season.
And losanga tere milioni ibiri kutu hawira gubora ni nya milioni ibiri ne kichweka kadimo kuseza abakozi takandi pangisize tini sanga tini ne kingoboro irimo
twina na basubuze abera mbaruga haranka gundugujiyo kasese kienjojo sazen tubarkwija haguro iro bwa ko nubu na matoka nko kuzikubaza takukanya kurungi mono mba so asenda nyingi transport ikinacho kibatalubaniza.
But a tomato farmer says that he has 450 tomato plants from the Netherlands, which is of high quality yield and grows up to 16 meters. He says that like any other farmer, tomato growing is affected by natural factors, especially rainstorm and too much sunshine. He uses an irrigation system where each tomato has an outlet that keeps the flow of water coming in. Since there is not enough water in the area, he was forced to introduce the National Water and Sewage Corporation system that he says is so expensive. Story compiled by Doreen Nansima for the news in Kabarole District.